the US and Canada, well, that trade fight continues. Days after Larry Kudlow accused Justin Trudeau of Canada of stabbing President Trump in the back. That's what he said. Joining us now, Ralph Goodale, a senior member of Prime Minister Trudeau's cabinet. So, welcome to the program. It's good to see you, sir.
Good morning.
Will you give us the latest? How do you respond to Larry Kudlow's comments?
Well, stay calm, stay focused, carry on, build the relationship and make sure that we're defending Canadian rights and interests. And look, today, a great announcement from FIFA about the World Cup coming to North America, a combination of Canada, the U.S. and Mexico, a great triumph for all three countries.
Well, on you Monday, sound like you're settling things down. You're settling things down. It was a kind of an ugly fight there, but you want to settle things down and calm the waters. Is that what you're doing?
Well, you look at that relationship between between Canada and the United States. That boundary between us is the longest, most open, most successful, unmilitarized boundary in the history of the world. 400,000 people go back and forth across that border every day. $2.5 billion in trade goes back and forth across that border every day. And it's roughly in balance in both directions. 35 American states depend upon trade with Canada for their economic well-being. 9 million American jobs depend on trade with Canada. We are the biggest U.S. export market, bigger than Japan and China and the United Kingdom combined. That relationship is big, it's important, and we will work very hard to make sure that it remains beneficial from the Canadian point of view and fair to everybody.
President Trump, at one point over the last few days, floated the idea of getting rid of all tariffs. What do you think about that? I mean, the obvious question is, well, why not?
Well, we are constantly working to improve the trade flows between our two countries. And quite frankly, the notion of imposing new tariffs on steel and aluminum is entirely counterproductive. We've indicated right from the very beginning that that is unacceptable from the Canadian point of view because the U.S. has a trade surplus in steel with Canada of about $2 billion a year, and we are the biggest U.S. market, for U.S. steel.
President Trump said, look, you guys in Canada, you impose a 270% tax, or tariff, I should say, on American dairy products going into Canada. Would you be prepared to reduce that tariff, lower it, as a sort of a goodwill gesture to make some peace with the president?
Well, to start with, that tariff is paid for by Canadian consumers, not by Americans. But still, you look at the agricultural trade between our two countries.
But would you be prepared will you make any arrangement here to cut back on that tariff or others like it? Is there any give and take at this point?
Oh, look, in the whole negotiation with respect to NAFTA that's been going on now for many months, Canada has been very proactive in putting forward constructive ideas on the table. We've been very firm in defending Canadian interests, but we've wanted a deal right from the very beginning. And we said this the moment President Trump raised the issue of a re-look at NAFTA, that we were prepared to have that re-look and to try to revise an agreement that's 20 or 25 years old, to bring it up to date and to make sure that it's a win-win-win for all three countries. And I note that Vice President Pence has made that comment too. It has to be a win for all three parties.
I think what President Trump wants is more trade, less tariffs, more trade. That is his end point. That's where he's going. You prepared to cut back on some tariffs that Canada currently imposes? I mean, is there any give there at all from Canada?
Well, as I said, we have made constructive proposals about how to improve the trade flows between both countries. And yes, we want more trade all throughout North America that is beneficial to all three countries. And we put those proposals on the table. The negotiators are working away at them. Our prime minister said not long ago that he saw the makings of a really good deal coming together around that table. The negotiators will hammer out the details, but we've made it very clear that we want an agreement that works well for all three countries and increases trade throughout North America.
Can I leave it
and
at
it's
this?
It's a huge relationship already. It's one that's been mutually beneficial in agriculture and in many other fields. To deal with dairy for a second, the U.S. has a trade surplus with Canada of $333 million a year. In fact, over the last 10 years, during the course of NAFTA, U.S. farm goods coming to Canada have increased by 46%. So it's an arrangement that is working. We can make it better.
Can I end it like this? Talks are ongoing. Negotiations continue. As of right now, they continue. The spat is to some degree behind us, and you would actively consider dropping, lowering some tariffs which Canada charges on American exports to Canada. Can I leave it at that?
To make sure that the deal works well for both countries. But understand this, we will defend Canadian interests and promote Canadian jobs. But we expect a deal that works well throughout North America for all the partners.
Got it.
And it's in everybody's interest to succeed on this. Can I finish with just one comment, though?
Sure.
The meeting on Monday in Singapore with respect to North Korea, that holds important potential for the peace and security of the world. And indeed, President Trump should be congratulated for taking that step.
Sounds like an olive branch, Minister.
Well, we want to have a constructive relationship, and we consider the facts and move on hard evidence and good ideas.
Okay, we got it. Ralph Goodale, sir, thank you very much for joining us this morning. We appreciate it.
My pleasure.
Yes, sir. Thank you
very much.
Thanks very much indeed.